गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान एंड आई वेलकम यू इन टुडेज सेगमेंट स्टूडेंट। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेगमेंट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन, सेकंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन एंड विद दिस वी हैव आल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सैम्पल प्रॉब्लम्स एंड एप्लीकेशन रिलेटेड टू दोज लॉज। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन स्टूडेंट, एंड दिस लॉ वी कैन से दैट इट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू आवर लाइफ। Because according to this, every action has equal and opposite reaction. Every action has equal and opposite reaction. And we follow this in our social life also. Because if we do good works or if we do good deeds, then we have the good result of those deeds. So if we do the good action, then in opposite we will have the good reaction or we get the good result. Like if you work hard, then you get the good marks. If you don't work hard, then you get the low marks or the poor marks. So this law we also follow in our daily life. According to this law student, when the force is applied on an object, then in opposite it also apply force on another object. In this there are the two bodies. When the two bodies interact with each other, then they apply the force on each other, and by the applying the force on each other there is equal and opposite reaction due to that action student. Like here, two balls are colliding with each other. It is the first ball, ball A, and it is the second ball, ball B. When this ball A applies the force on this, then this ball also applies the force on the ball A, means ball B also applies the force on ball B. So there is one action takes place by the force AB, means the force that will be applied by this ball, it will have the opposite force also from this ball, ball B to A. And this action will be considered as action, and this action will be considered as reaction. So every action has the equal and opposite reaction. According to this, every action has equal and opposite reaction. Now what is the action, student? Action means the force applied by one object. And what is the reaction? In opposite force, means the force that is applied by another object towards the object that is applying the force. Means applied force is always equal to the opposed force. So according to this law, it is applicable to the nature of the force, means which type of force we use here. Second, every action and reaction always act on different bodies. Like action is applying on this and reaction is applying on this. So action and reaction always act on different bodies. Third important point about this, student, force cannot cancel each other. Means these forces are not cancelling each other. If they will cancel each other, then there will be no action, or the object will come in the rest. So forces cannot cancel each other. Next important point related to this last, student, no reaction can be occur in the absence of action. Means if we do the action, then we get the reaction. If we don't do the action, then we will not have the reaction. Like If we run or walk or play, then what we do? We take the first step. And by taking the first step, automatically we take the second in the form of reaction. So with the help of action and reaction, we walk, student. Like this, when a bullet is fired from a gun, then due to that firing of the bullet, that gun is recoiled back. And that recoiling is reaction. And what is action here, student? Firing of the bullet. Like this, when a boatman comes out from a boat, then that boat moves in backward direction and the boatman moves in forward direction. So the movement of the boatman in the forward direction is action, and the movement of the boat in the backward direction is reaction. So action and reaction is involved in different activities of the life. Like if we remove one arrow from the bow, then what we do? We stretch that bow like this with the help of the string or the thread that is found inside the bow. So with the help of the stretching, what we provide to that bow, we provide force to that, and that force is in the form of action. And in the reaction, that bow applies the force on the arrow, and the arrow moves in the forward direction. So here also the action and reaction law we follow, student. Like this, rockets are launched. All the rockets are launched with the help of action and reaction law. Means when the rocket are launched, then what they remove? They remove the exhaust. Different gases are exhausted. Due to that action, there is one reaction is taken place, student, from which the rocket is launched in the forward direction, in the upward direction. So it is also the example of action and reaction law. Now in this force AB is equal to reaction, means FBA. And with the help of this, there is one physical quantity is conserved, student. And that quantity is known as momentum. Or we can say, due to the action and reaction law, we can conserve the momentum. Momentum is conserved, student. Because that momentum is converted in the form of reaction. Means when the objects collide with each other, then there is reaction takes place. So action and reaction conserve the momentum. And there is one law, student, and that law is known as law of conservation of momentum. And about this law, we will discuss in our next segment. Now what will you do? You will write this law in your notebook. Third law of motion or action and reaction law. And you will also follow it in your life, student. And try to do always the good deeds. And due to having the good deeds, you will have the good result. Means if you will work hard, then you will get the good marks. If you will not work hard, then you may get the poor marks. So try to do the good deeds in your life. Thank you very much and have a pleasant day.